So, just as a quick addendum to the last one, I remembered I had read a thing, and I've just rediscovered it. May 2020, Rutger Bregman wrote an article in The Guardian called "The Real Lord of the Flies: What Happened When Six Boys Were Shipwrecked for 15 Months." And the Lord of the Flies is a famous novel by William Golding that was published, written in 51, published in 54, I think, and became a huge worldwide bestseller. Obviously, first in English. And it's this story of what happens with human nature: boys shipwrecked on a desert island, and what horrors ensue. Following the various assumptions and presumptions and orthodoxies about what human nature is. Well, in 1966, a real group of boys, five, I think, five boys, are rescued. Been in a very similar situation, Tonga, yeah. And apparently, the exact opposite happened. They agreed to not argue. They agreed to run their lives democratically. They survived, and the 50-odd years later, many of them were still in touch. Now old men, and they'd have reunions. So there you have it. I just think that's a very interesting notion that what comes out of the imagination of a well-educated English person in the mid-20th century and then captures our imagination. It reminds me of this absolute glut of Hollywood movies, which are all about horror and terror. And behind every tree there stands a man with a chainsaw kind of idea. And I actually have friends who are very affected by this stuff, and there's certain places they won't go at certain times of day or night because of it, and the true crime fascination and things like that. So, it's interesting how much of our existence is actually made up of our unacknowledged predisposition towards depravity, when the truth is a lot brighter. Think about it.